So Megha, how was your school life till class 10th? Were you a studious person? Were you a nerd? Were you a bookworm? Or were you a person who used to enjoy her life?
First of all, till class 12th, I did regular schooling. I didn't go to a dummy school.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I preferred going to a regular school because I think that other co-scholastic activities are too important in development. And for the competitive exams, I am an NTC scholar and a KVPY scholar too.
Oh, that's great. So, as you heard, that Megha went to regular school till class 12th. And why did you use PCB stream?
Since the very beginning, that image of a doctor with a stethoscope and treating patients, that motivated me, inspired me to become a doctor. And I liked biology from the very beginning only. So that made me choose PCB.
So was the hatred towards mathematics one of the factors that compelled you to take PCB?
No, it was not like that. Like, I liked physics a lot. So mathematics portion also I was comfortable with, but biology I liked more.
Okay. So that's cool. So I have heard like that was one of my reasons why I took biology, because I did not like mathematics at all. So that is a good thing that she was good in mathematics. Still, she chose biology just because of her interest, not because of any kind of compulsion or hatred for a particular subject. So did you prepare for AIIMS or NEET examination while you were in class 11th or 12th?
Yeah, actually I'm a dropper. So till class 12th I did go to a coaching, but till class 12th I was not very much into studies. I was in other co-scholastic activities, so I took a drop.
Other co-scholastic activities as in?
Dancing.
So yeah, what kind of dance do you specialize in?
Contemporary and basically folk dances. I'm from Rajasthan, so Rajasthani dances.
Okay. So what kind of Rajasthani folk dances are common?
Ghumar.
Yeah. Right. Have you seen Amisha Maru's Ghumar dance?
Yeah. She really does it very well.
Yeah. Even I do appreciate it a lot.
Yeah. My rank with class 12th, the first attempt, it was 12,000 something. So, was a very difficult decision for me to take a drop because...
What do you feel was the reason that you got such a low rank in thousands? Why do you feel, could you have done better, or this was what you deserved from the amount of preparation that you had done?
That thing I wanted to discuss in quite detail. There were a lot of factors which I feel like I shouldn't have done. So starting with, I didn't prepare NCERT properly. That is the thing which I feel like a lot of students, they do, that they go to random books, they try solving numerous questions, but they miss out the very basic thing, that is NCERT textbook, especially biology. So this thing I feel like I shouldn't have done. I should have read NCERT properly. And then I used to postpone things to tomorrow. I didn't do daily revision. That was perhaps very important. And plus I was in a regular school, so I didn't get much time to practice questions a lot. And I used to give impetus much to theory than questions. So I used to read my notes again and again instead of practicing a lot of questions. So that shouldn't be done. Proper time should be given to question practice also. So those were the factors which, you know, led me to 12,000 rank.
Okay, so in 12,000 rank, you could have got a seat in some peripheral medical college.
Yeah, I was getting the payment seats of quite low colleges of Rajasthan.
Right, you could have easily gotten into various colleges of BDS that have some kind of reputation, not the private medical colleges.
Yeah.
So why didn't you opt for BDS or a private medical college?
It was from the very beginning, I was destined that I have to be an MBBS from a very good college. Obviously, I didn't thought of AIIMS. AIIMS is like the topmost thing, but still, I had in my mind that if I'm going to be a doctor, it should be from a good college. So I was quite stubborn on that thinking, no, not BDS, not private college, MBBS from a very good college.
Okay. So friends, as you can appreciate, that constant burning fire inside her motivated her to pursue her dream even after a failure. So we should all take an inspiration from her, that whatever we do, whatever we achieve, until and unless our aim is reached, we should not stop. We should keep on trying again and again. So, like, since you are a girl, like, and there are various apprehensions in the society, ki yaar ladki hai, jo bhi hai, jo college mil raha hai, kara do, waise hi jana hai. Aur uske alawa drop lene ke bare mein bhi log kaafi cheeze bolte hain ki jaise I'm quite sure ki jab teri 12,000 rank aayegi, logon ne bola hoga ki agar aap isko kahin dilwa bhi do, drop dilwa do, jo zyada se zyada 12,000 se 1200 aa jayegi, 1200 se ek rank upar to nahi aani iski. To इसमें कॉन्फिडेंस तुम्हें कैसे आया? हाँ. किस तुम्हारे का मम्मी का कैसा सपोर्ट था, पापा का कैसा सपोर्ट था, सिबलिंग्स का कैसा सपोर्ट था?
My parents and my siblings, they always supported me, but the peripheral society like neighbors and relatives, they told ki MBBS is not that important, you can do from a low college, PG is what that matters. But still my parents were always like, ki, no, 1 year is all right, it's not a big deal, even in medical field taking a drop is not a big thing. So my parents always supported my decision of taking drop, and they were like, we will support you, anything you need. So I got that constant support and motivation from my parents. And plus it was my intense desire that I have to reach a good college. So that was the biggest motivation factor for me.
So as can be inferred from what she showed, that her intense desire toward achieving her aim or towards achieving or getting into her dream college was the main factor. And apart from that, the support from her parents and her siblings mattered a lot for her. So 12th ho gaya, you got 93% in board examination. Then you got into dropper's badge. Dropper's badge of which coaching institute?
Allen Jaipur.
Okay. So Allen Jaipur mein jaisa aapne admission liya, to kab se classes chalu hui aur fir kya hua? So jo sabse important cheez droppers ke dimag mein confusion hota hai ki humne 11th 12th mein kuch padhai ki hai jo humne shayad acche se nahi ki hai, ya kuch cheez acche se ki hai kuch cheez acche se nahi ki hai. To hum kya shuruaat se padhna chalu kare या जो चीजें हमने पढ़ी हैं उनको रिवाइज करके उन्हें इंप्रूव करें. सो व्हिच स्ट्रेटजी डिड यू अडॉप्ट?
पर्सनली आई स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द वेरी बिगनिंग, फ्रॉम द जीरो. आई यूज्ड टू मेक कंप्लीट क्लास नोट्स. इन माय क्लास आई यूज्ड टू सी अदर ड्रॉपर्स, दे थॉट कि एक बार तो लिख लिया है, सो दे यूज्ड टू रीएडिट द प्रीवियस नोट्स. बट आई वुड नॉट सजेस्ट दैट. मेक द नोट्स अगेन, रीड एनसीईआरटी फ्रॉम लाइक यू आर डूइंग इट फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, बिकॉज इफ इट वुड हैव बीन बेटर यू वुड हैव गॉट अ कॉलेज ना. सो you couldn't make it to AIIMS or good college means you have flaws. So don't think you know something. Start from the very beginning, make notes, read NCERT line by line. That's it.
Okay, so you were in Allen's dropper's batch. So did you go for regular tests that they organized, fortnightly tests, weekly tests, monthly tests?
Yeah, there were tests in 21 days. Okay. So they were quite helpful in assessing ki how are we doing.
Okay, so what are some other tips that you would like to give other aspirants who are preparing for AIIMS and NEET and other various examinations?
The very first thing which I would like to suggest is don't go here and there. Refer to your NCERT only, especially physics and chemistry. For AIIMS especially, summary, points to ponder, they are very important. Generally, even if students read NCERT, they neglect the blue boxes and everything. They are very important, plus the in-text questions in chemistry, organic and physical, they are very important. And whichever coaching institute you are going to, make sure ki you pursue the material of one or two coaching institutes. Matlab, don't go here and there, and that way you don't focus on one thing properly. It's not a good thing. So I personally did Allen and Akash modules and NCERT, all the questions. Second thing is that making short notes is very important, because in the last, when you have a lot of syllabus, it becomes difficult to revise theory. So for that, make one page short notes of each chapter. And try to practice as many questions as you can, again from NCERT and your modules only. And being regular is very important. You should be regular in your studies, and daily revision is also very important. Whatever is taught in the class, make sure that the very same day you remember all the stuff. And just don't postpone things to tomorrow. Yeah.
So basically, if you try to procrastinate things, that can prove disastrous for you.
Yeah.
So कल करे सो आज कर, आज करे सो अब. तो आज का काम आज ही खत्म करना है, कल के लिए नहीं छोड़ना है, ठीक है? दैट इज व्हाट मेगा वांटेड टू से. सो मेगा, कुछ लोग होते हैं, जैसे आप एलन में जाओ या आकाश में जाओ, तो एटलीस्ट 50 की बैच साइज होती है, और एलन में जो नॉर्मल बैचेस जाती हैं उनकी साइज 150, 200, 300, 350 तक भी जाती है जितना मैंने सुना है. तो हर कोई कंफर्टेबल नहीं होता. अगर आपको कोई डाउट्स हैं, या हर किसी के पढ़ने का रेट अलग अलग होता है, जैसे कि मैं तेज़ पढ़ता हूँ तो मुझे लगेगा कि क्लास में मेरा टाइम वेस्ट हो रहा है. मैं अगर धीरे पढ़ता हूँ और प्रोफेसर तेज स्पीड से पढ़ा रहे हैं तो मुझे लगेगा कि यार मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा. और कुछ डाउट्स आते हैं नेचुरली, तो वो हम क्लास में क्लियर नहीं कर पाते. तो उसके लिए आजकल ऑनलाइन स्टडी प्लेटफॉर्म्स आर कमिंग, एंड ऑफ दैट वन ऑफ देम आई हैव विद मी प्रेप ऑनलाइन. सो ये देखो, ये प्रेप ऑनलाइन का ऐप है. सो You can get it at the fee. Okay, you have seen this?
Yeah, I've seen this.
Okay, so इसमें Prep Online के app में we can get video lectures, like we have physics 11th, chemistry 11th, biology 11th, and correspondingly for class 12th also. So in a particular chapter of a particular class, like you have a chapter, the living world. So this chapter has been divided into 7 parts, 7 small parts, and there is a video for each part. After you have seen the video, you can go through the question banks. There are 2 question banks. One is, there are topic wise question banks, like what is living, 10 questions on that, diversity in living world, 10 questions on that, and so. Then you have question bank 2, which has questions from the NCERT exemplar, one of the section. Then we have 30 NCERT based questions, we have match the column type questions, and we have advanced level questions. So there are some questions in NEET which are very easy, some which are of moderate level, and some which are of higher order thinking skills. So for that also, they have tried to encompass that in this wonderful app that they have prepared. Apart from that, as everybody knows, assistant and reason type of questions are very important from AIIMS point of view. So in every chapter, they have incorporated assistant and reason type of questions into the app. Not only video lectures and question answers, question banks, we have various model test papers of the half of the syllabus, one third of the syllabus, the entire syllabus of class 11th, class 12th, right? And you can get this wonderful app at a nominal fees. Apart from that, there are also videos of various toppers, like the one in which Megha is giving her tips. So toppers of various years and various streams, the videos are available on the app. You can go through them and you can take guidance from the toppers regarding your preparations. Apart from that, you can share the link to this app to your friends, and if they download it, you will get some credits which you can subsequently use to unlock new videos and newer tests. So Megha, would you recommend this app?
Yeah, I personally found that this app is quite organized. So those students who find trouble in organizing their schedule or managing problems, they can use this. Matlab, it provides a step-by-step way to reach out things. So yeah, this app is very helpful.
Nice. Okay friends, keep watching AIIMS for AIIMS.